Regel vor, ist, ob es partners in those positions in diesem Gericht ja weiß ich so, was ist das Forum, der wir exchange ideas about the future, der wir interact with each other, our justice outside these doors, es ist zeigen, was some of the suppliers prepare, how our future might look like, and I think we are going forward the right direction. And I will just start with a little recap from last year. You all remember last year, when we met here in Duna, we just witnessed VS4 implementation, right? VS4 launch. So, some of us were a little bit celebrating, some were depressed because of the high stock level. And what was even more of a concern last year was what? GSD was knocking on the door. And nobody of us was really sure what will happen with GSD. What will it bring? Will the customer come to us? Will they buy our vehicles? Will they hold back? Actually, we started for some 2 months. But since the implementation of GSD, we see the market is growing. And it's really growing in a way we have never seen before. So we're all taking in much higher numbers, are looking in much higher numbers than we have seen before. And it's clear, there was a huge backlog from the past because there is a need for maneuvers, there's a need for modern vehicles, for modern tracking. But what I think is even more important is one thing. The customer buying criteria completely changed. In the past, the Indian fleet owners, drive drivers, there's no for one single million. They are cost consciousness. So, anyways, always. In the meanwhile, this is their price. Value consciousness. More and more decisions are made based on TCO, more and more decisions are made because of one thing. Since all border controls have been eliminated, all authorization have been eliminated, the trucks run more than 20,000 kilometers per month, all over 20,000 kilometers per month in a year. And of it in the past, right? Totally different. And this is now a self-propelling situation. And I would say this makes us really hopeful that this year, most likely next year, to the year afterwards, extremely good. But when I came to today, I had one number in my mind. It's the number 706. What do you think 706 stands for? Any idea? The 706 days is the 1st of April 2020. That's launch ES6. So there we mix the parts new, then we have different situation. So means next 3 years, or next 3 years is not 3 years, it's only 706 days, we need 2 years anymore. And you see complete new technology. But if I compare the drug industry to some other industry, I would say guys, we have enough time for really significant changes. We should not do only for the bare minimum change. We really have to address what the society wants from us. I just make a little bit of comparison. Some years ago, when we wanted to travel, we ordered a taxi or we went to a taxi store, right? Some of us even downloaded music and then we sleep player. So, this is one thing. No TV was connected to the internet, right? So today, years down the road already, I would say, you call an Uber car, you call an Uber car, and your smartphone. Most likely you have your music on your smartphone, if you have all downloaded it, or if you stream it. 11 billion devices are connected to the internet, not knowing what? Smartphone, tablets, computers. This means we are in times where everything changed. And for us, in the commercial vehicle industry, our question is, do we want to sit in the driver's seat? Or do we want to be driven? Because this kind of changes, also connectivity becomes to the drivers more and more. And also us, we should come to the drivers more and more. Do we want say, come on, we have our ideas. We know what we want to do. But this means also for us, we have to look out. I don't want how to make a too colorful future. I want to look a little bit now on environment, safety features, and so on. What is really necessary? If I look at our business environment, where we are in India, I was recently in a panel discussion with some colleagues from Walmart, IKEA, and you know what? Interestingly, we all share the same opinion. Lots of opportunities in India, undoubtedly. What is missing in India? There is no clear rule book available. How's the future will look like? There are some iterative things from the government which pops up overnight. High import duties, all of a sudden to change the business. But a clear rule book, a clear guideline for us would help us. But I just want to make a comparison with China. China, the Chinese government knows exactly. They would never have been in a position to compete with global players and fast challenges. They invest heavily in what? And electric vehicles. And they clean abundant sources. In India, we just opposite. There is no abundant resources. There is no really clear guideline in this. But we remain this obsolete, old-fashioned processing systems where we waste a lot of money. And one example which I always like is one thing. We all know we have to homologate the vehicles and we need SAA approval, right? 26 states, 26 different rulebooks. We have to apply every state more or less. We homologate the vehicles and we go to the state. There's a clear reason behind, because more co-dealers are also to register their vehicle. I can access my bank account in Germany in a split second from India. Any doubt? No doubt. You all know this. You know what I cannot do? I cannot register a vehicle online and legally from Chennai. All trucks, all vehicles need to go more or less to the customer at his destination for the final registration. And that's just do the math. If we have around 250,000 vehicles, if this 250,000 vehicles drive 500 kilometers, this is more or less 125 liters, which you burn only from a factory to the final customer. 250,000 liters is a load, more than 30 million liters of fees. And other costs. There's a saving potential here of more than 240 if you think that. But I have a very concentrated number, which we just based. This was said. There's no rule book, there's easy things which we could modernize, we could register legal at a global scale. Nobody would be harmed, it would be easier for us to put simplified processes. Is somebody working on it in this government? No, not really. This is where I said, where we, as industry, also have to raise our voice and say, guys, yes, we understand PSX, we understand that we want to invest, we have to invest, we are willing to do this, but we need also the government to change the rules. Same thing is regarding infrastructure. I'm happy to see all this kind of investments in new homes, in new equipment. Wonderful. And it helps all of us. And honestly, I cannot produce enough givers. No way, I don't get enough funds. That's a sad story. But if I really make a scene analysis, degree analysis, there's one thing which concerns me. We want India to convert an exporter. All of us. Did Mr. Modi not say, make in India, export to the world? How many deepwater harbors do we have in India? One, the Adani port. Who of you has a plant close to the Adani port? Nobody. This means that we have a ship goods out from here to the Middle East or maybe to Latin America. We have to onboard again in Singapore. And said, cost saving, which we think we have in the Indian industry, melts like butter in the sun. That is something which we could really do. Safety, we have discussed this several times here. For example, I'm still a team guy in air conditions, and I now am extremely happy to see the change in air conditions, which is like that. Because everybody understands it's a meanwhile, air conditions take a lot of fuel, so it's
about saving fuel, which is good,
but it's also about saving
equipment.
But are we really concerned about saving equipment? I love to see that we want to apply this equipment, and we want to take these old heaters out, but do we want to take on the way home today? You look at the beam in front of you, the lighting system works, if the tires can have some pattern on it, you say something forward left. You will see a lot of this vehicle will be totally normally not usable in a normal situation. And still, no policeman is stopping this vehicle, only to say sorry. He's hungry and then he might stop the vehicle. And at the same time, we could do more. We want to do more. We all work on modern carriages and all the things. But you know what? As long as our savings go backward, a lot of the business is taken away from us. And I want it is modernization of this industry. Because as long as we put in these old obsolete vehicles, it's poor visibility. As long as in the best area portal is available for this vehicle, no wonder that we have the highest cash rate in the world. Official number under 50,000 cash receipts. This is 5 times higher than somewhere else in the world. So, coming back to BS6. BS6, my dear friends, is the biggest opportunity for us. It's not a threat. Why is it so? Finally, we lift ourselves up. We come to a global level. We offer it our customer really similar vehicle as anybody else's, but there is one thing we are really going to emerge. I have been asked several times when it comes to modern technology, different forms. From whom do we get the technology? Who provides me this, this, and this? And this approach is totally wrong. Nobody else has better resource than India. We have the most engineers in the world.